Our first speaker this morning is Mr. Hussein Ali Al-Karafi. Mr. Karafi is a graduate of the American University of Beirut and a prominent industrial manufacturer in the state of Kuwait. He is a managing director of Khalid Al-Karafi and Brothers Company and member of the Board of Trustees, Australian College of Kuwait. Most significantly for today's symposium, Mr. Al-Karafi is also chairman of the Kuwait Industries Union. Please welcome to the podium, Mr. Hussein Ali Al-Karafi.
Good morning. The title of my address is Industry Awareness of the Need for a Positive Health and Safety Culture and the Way to Achieve It. This address highlights three questions. What is a positive health and safety culture? Second, what is the industry awareness of a positive health and safety culture? Three, what steps can we take to achieve it? Today, I'm speaking to you with many voices at the same time. You will hear from me as a chairman of Kuwait Industries Union, as an industrialist, as a businessman, and as a family man. Why all these different voices? Because health and safety does matter. Health and safety is not just something confined to the workplace. Health and safety has an impact on the community, industry, families, and the country. So, addressing the first question, what is the positive health and safety culture? The culture of the organization is a reflection of how things get done in that organization. So, a health and safety culture is about how health and safety is treated in the organization. Any organization that does not have a plan for safety, which includes risk assessment, provision of proper safety equipment and training for its people, and safely is sending a clear message to everyone in the organization that health and safety is not important. And these type of organizations, accident investigations look for someone to blame rather than looking for the root cause of the incident. Behaviors like these are indicators of a negative safety culture. A positive safety culture is one where there is a high awareness of safety and a strong commitment to the achievement of a safe workplace. A positive safety culture is one where workers wear safety equipment because they understand why it is for their protection. Positive safety culture is one where proper risk assessments are done and workers are made aware of risk, hazards, and control measures. Health and safety is about the lives of people. As employers, our motto should be, everyone who comes to work should safely go home from work. Health and safety does not just apply to hazardous occupation or to special industries such as construction and manufacturing and oil. It also applies to industries such as health, food, hospitality, security, tourism, banking, retail, and aviation. It is something everyone should be aware of. A positive health and safety culture should be part of every company, no matter what it does. My second question is, what is the industry awareness of a positive health and safety culture? There is no doubt that industry is aware of health and safety. It gets reminded of health and safety every time there is an accident, unfortunate accident, where a worker is hurt. I question whether there is enough awareness in industry about a positive health and safety culture. In industry, we are aware of the legal requirements we have to comply with. It's clear that health and safety is covered in international conventions and national legislation. There are good laws, but they are not being adequately enforced. Enforcement is most likely to occur as a result of a serious accident rather than occurring before the accident has the opportunity to take place. That is, it's a reaction, actually. Enforcement is more likely to occur as a result of serious accident. Health and safety inspectors need to be more vigilant in their applications of the law. By vigilant, I mean that their enforcement should be relevant to the risk assessed and the hazards caused by the breach. They need to be continually trained and aware of the new practices and standards. They have a critical role to play in making sure that health and safety matters in Kuwait. In industry, we are also aware of the financial side of health and safety. Health and safety needs to be viewed as an investment rather than a cost. The cost of non-compliance is far greater than the investment in compliance. I remember a saying somebody told me, well, safety, this is inexpensive. And somebody replies to him, say, if safety is expensive, wait until you have an accident. Workplace accidents especially have serious financial impact of the business. The hidden costs are those that get ignored until an accident happens. Consider the disruption of the flow of work resulting from the loss of employees' input. The cost becomes even greater if the accident involves a skilled worker who you have already made an investment in training and building his skills. Think about the morale of your employees knowing that a work colleague and friend has been injured or killed. How will they feel about you, their employer, if they know the accident could have been avoided? And what about your reputation and how that could flow on the affecting your chances of winning a contract in the future? When the hidden costs are fully thought through, then an emphasis on health and safety makes great financial sense. I mentioned about winning future contracts. If you are looking to win a contract in the oil sector, for example, you have to be able to demonstrate that you, as a contractor, can comply with the very detailed standards set by the oil sector. For example, KMPC publishes a comprehensive 58-page document, HSC Guidelines for Contractors. This document spells out the minimum health and safety requirement, including in the preparation of HSC plans, having an HSC management system, HSC inspections and audits, provisions of suitably qualified safety staff, adequate training for staff, HSC policies, HSC KPIs, communications record keeping, and so forth. Going back to my question, what is industry's awareness of a positive health and safety culture? I put the question back to you. As representatives of Kuwait industry, how aware is your organization its health safety culture? Is it positive or negative? My third question, what steps can we take to achieve a positive health and safety culture? Most companies employ accountants to look after their finances. They employ IT professionals to look after their computers. Why do they not employ health and safety experts to look after their people? Organizations need to have an awareness of their obligations, responsibilities, and their needs when it comes to health and safety. General awareness comes from the gatherings, such as this symposium. Specific awareness comes from actively seeking help. Such help is available through consulting with the health and safety experts. Consultations helps bring things into focus. Through experts' consultations, organizations can make informed decisions as to where they are going with the health and safety and what resources are needed to get there, to survive into the future. Organizations must have three things for a positive health and safety culture: commitment, time, money. Without these three key elements, organizations will find great difficulties in dealing with larger contractors, especially in securing business with the oil sector. Commitment costs nothing in dinars. Commitment comes from you, the top management, and leaders of Kuwait organizations. Commitment needs to be driven so that it flows through all of the layers of the organization. You have to lead by example. When you place an emphasis on safety, then it will become a priority for your staff. When safety is accepted as a priority, it will become part of your organizational culture. It needs to become as natural as breathing. Time is money, but it is how the time is used that determines the true value of the efforts. Ignore health and safety and you save time. Until a serious accident occurs, then you will find that it takes up more time than you have. Ignoring health and safety is not a wise investment at all. Planning for a safety and health workplace will take time, but it is a worthwhile investment. Your safe workplace will be somewhere workers will want to come because they will have the confidence that when they come to work, they will be able to return from work safely for their families. Money is something we need to put into health and safety. Organizations need to have the financial capacity to implement and maintain safe working environments. Expert consultancies cost money, and so does the training that all employees and safety officers will need. Maybe Kuwait should consider some form of government subsidy, especially for the small and medium-sized enterprises, to assist them to develop safety management system and training their people to work safely. It is better to subsidize safety training than to have subsidized hospitals to treat those injured in workplace accidents. How to train our people is a major challenge. Again, commitment, time, and money are key elements. Training should occur at all levels and include top management, middle management, and the general workforce. We need to be aware of that the training is more than running some courses, and that training has to result in a sustained change in employee behavior. An example on industry is how do we encourage workers to wear personal protective equipment to be safe? We know that in many cases, if employees are not constantly supervised, they will not wear PPE. We can impose penalties on them, but does that make them want to wear safety equipment? They need to be made more aware of the hazards. They need to be aware of the consequences of the accidents. They need to be more aware of the impact an accident will have on their families and their business. They need to think about their children having a disabled parent who cannot come play with them. We need to appeal to their emotional side that gives them a real reason to be safe and not take unnecessary risks. Health and safety training cannot be just a part of the workers' induction training. It needs to be constantly and persistently applied for the message to get through and make the changes to safe behavior. Having professionally educated health and safety trainers accredited by internationally recognized bodies such as NIBOSH and IOSH will ensure that health and safety training in Kuwait is world-class standard. When it comes to health, safety, and our people, we do not want anything less than world-class standards. Our employees do not deserve anything less. When you leave this symposium today, you have two choices. You can do nothing and be guaranteed that nothing will change for the better, or you can make a commitment to do something and take action towards making a safer Kuwait. As employers, we are legally and morally responsible for health and safety. It does not matter if you employ one person or 1,000 people. It is a fact of life. Health and safety does matter. Remember the motto I gave you earlier in this presentation? Everyone who comes to work should safely go home from work. Thank you very much indeed.